Not that many people have heard of Henkel. This is our logo. Henkel is actually three separate specialty chemical companies, and a laundry care company, a beauty care company, and the company that I'm part of, which is the adhesives division. You may recognize some of the brands up there. You may recognize also some of our pitch people. So we have this gentleman here in the white dinner jacket who represents Persil. You may have seen him during football season last year. And our beauty care products are represented by Heidi Klum. I think most of you will recognize her. We didn't have anybody for adhesives for my division until, well, we do now. Do you know who it is? Anybody know who it is? Okay, well, he came out in the Super Bowl, and he was one of the top five ads. And maybe there'll be in a couple weeks we'll see him again. I don't know. This is our guy here, Loctite Louis. Loctite Louis. So we have suave, beautiful, capable. He's a doer, not a poser. That's what I like to say anyway. The adhesives group is the largest adhesives company in the world. We have 14% of the market. Sales are about $11 billion. And like many specialty chemical companies, we have a huge number of applications. So we do everything from bonding two-ply toilet paper together to putting aerospace composites, bonding the fibers together, bonding integrated circuits, sealing windows, a wide range of applications. What makes adhesives a specialty chemical, and what makes anything a specialty chemical? A specialty chemical is something that when you're trying to use it, it's not that straightforward. You could mess up, and or the application of this material is always changing with time. And so the symptom of a specialty chemical business is that it requires a lot of technical service. So if you'd have to hold the customer's hand very often, then you probably have a specialty chemical business. And adhesives fits that very nicely because we have a variety of substrates which change with time, as do the processes, and adhesives can be applied wrong. And if they are applied wrong, you can have a very expensive device not work. So customers need a lot of support from us. So why are we looking at startups? So we're specialty chemicals, we got a lot of different chemistry, have probably 20, 25 different classes of chemistry that we deal with. What we're looking for from startups is two things, access and culture. So we're looking for access to new, and when I say new, I mean really new, technologies and applications and the associated emerging markets and adjacent markets to adhesives. And a lot of that's coming out of universities, so it's a way to tap into that entrepreneurial spirit, which I went to Berkeley a long time ago, and it's changed quite a bit, I think, in terms of the ability for universities to work with industry in a very productive fashion. And these startups are willing to take risks that it's just not easy to do in a big company. It just doesn't work. And that's where the culture comes in. What we like to do, what we're trying to do with Dropwise, which you, Adam Paxson, talked a little bit earlier, is we want to work with startups that we can really partner with for two reasons. One, we have something to bring to the party. That is, we connect with almost every single industry, so we can bring them access to customers. We also have, as I said, a lot of technology, a lot of analytical and testing capability, which can support them. So we're hoping to give them something. And at the same time, because we're partnering, we expect to get a very in-depth knowledge of the application that they're going after so that we can know early on, is it going to be a winner or is it not going to be a winner? In the ideal case, we get in early, we invest along the way, we help them to grow faster than they would otherwise, and we acquire them when they get big. That's our goal. We've invested in two startups in the last year. Dropwise, you heard about earlier this morning. Another one in California is Vitriflex, which is a barrier film for display panels as well as for photovoltaics. And And we're interested in a number of other areas that we think we have. Again, the key thing for us is some sort of synergy. We need to bring something to the party. So one area that looks particularly promising that we're looking at right now is 3D printing. And there are a number of others up there. So with that, I'd like to say thank you and look for Loctite Louis in a couple weeks.